Hello friends, today we are going to see some basic concept related to the unit 3, resolutions and composition of forces. Now the first question comes in our mind, what is meant by the resolution and what is meant by the composition of forces? So we will see step by step each point, and I will try to clear all the concept of yours related to the unit number 3. Then on the basis we will see the examples at the last of the theory point. Okay, now come to the first thing, what is meant by the resolution? So the step is here, resolution, the way of representing a single force into the number of forces without changing its effect of the force on the body is called as the resolution of forces. Now what that mean exactly? This is all about the definition, but exactly what mean by the resolutions? Just take the example, if I consider the one vehicle, okay, consider this is my vehicle, and if I tie one rope to the vehicle and try to pull it, then so I consider this pulling force as a F force. And due to the F force, if the vehicle is moving 5 meters, okay, then this is the first condition for you. Now I tell you the another example, again the vehicle I will consider, and instead of the one force I will apply the two forces here, but not directly perpendicular to the vehicle. I will take the certain angles in between the each forces, okay, this forces. So I will consider this force as the F1 force and this is as the F2 force, correct? And just because of these two forces, F1 and F2, if the vehicle is moving again the 5 meters, if due to the F1 and F2 forces, if the vehicle is moving 5 meter distance, that means I will say, that means I can say the F force will be directly proportional or is equal to the addition of these two forces. That means we can write here the F, we can write here F is equal to the additions of two forces F1 plus F2, F1 plus F2, correct? So if I do the additions of these two forces, or then I will get the F force. So this is called it as a resolution, means I have resolved the one forces into the two component. So how we can show it? We can show these forces by this arrow, okay? So this will be the F1 force and this will be the F2 force, and these two forces we are getting when we resolve the F force, okay? Or we can say also in a another way, that if you want to find out the applied force in this direction, then you can easily find out by the component. If I want to find out the downward force acting on the vehicle, or that is the F2, then I can easily find out by using the resolution component. Okay, that effect. The basic thing is, what is meant by resolution? So resolution means representing the single force into the number of forces, representing the single force into the number of forces without changing its effect. Due to the F, the vehicle was moving 5 meters, and due to these two forces, the vehicle also was moving the 5 meters without changing its effect of the force on the body. Body means the vehicle, is called as the resolution of the forces, correct? Then come to the next point. Now how many ways we can do the resolution. Again, the question: what are the different methods for the resolution of the forces? So basically, the two methods for the resolutions of the forces. Here in the slide, we can see the two methods. First, A method is resolution into the two mutually perpendicular component, means the component we are getting due to the resolution of F will be perpendicular to the each other. So two mutually perpendicular component, or we can call it as a orthogonal component. This is the second name, okay, because both the forces are perpendicular to each other in 90. And second step is the resolution into non-perpendicular. That means the angle between the two resolved component will not be 90 degree. For the first case, resolution of two mutually perpendicular component. So mutually perpendicular means when we resolve the F force, so due to the resolution of force, the angle between the two forces F1 and F2 will be 90 degree. So this will be the mutually perpendicular component. And the second step is non-perpendicular. That means in this case, the angle between the two forces, angle between the two forces will not be 90 degree, okay. So this is the non-perpendicular or non-orthogonal component, okay.
Yeah.
This is the simple method of resolution of forces. These are the two methods. Now come to the second step. Now second thing is how we can find out the component. I will show here the two components. First of all, resolution into the two mutual perpendicular method. So before going to this concept, I will show you the one thing, that consider the quadrant system. The first quadrant is the second quadrant, third and fourth quadrant. These are the four quadrant into the quadrant system. Now this force is in the first quadrant system. You can see easily, if I draw the quadrant system, then this is the origin center. So I will consider, and the F is moving from this point to on away from the origin. So this is the F force, okay. So in the quadrant, horizontal axis is the x axis, vertical axis is the y axis, okay. So F is moving away from the origin, and if I tell you to resolve the F force by using the two mutual perpendicular method or orthogonal component method, then directly resolve the force F into the two component. One will be the horizontal component and one will be the vertical component. Horizontal component will be parallel to the x axis and vertical component will be parallel to the y axis. Now we can represent that component also on the x and y axis too, but for our clearance purpose, I am not going to show this component on the x and y axis. I am showing it on the F line, okay. So this force is on the x axis, that's why the force component will be Fx, and this force is on the y axis, so this component will be Fy, correct? I think you got. According to the quadrant system, you have to think more. So I will resolve this F component here. So this and this, okay. So this component will be Fx and the vertical component will be Fy, correct? Fy. This is all about the resolution. Okay. Now the second state, in the second non-perpendicular case, we have the one F force, and we have resolved into the two forces F1 and F2. F1 and F making the alpha angle, and F2 and F making the beta angle. So these are the different thing. F1 and F making alpha angle, and F and F2 making the beta angle. Now this is all about the resolution of forces. We will see this resolution in detail. Don't worry about it. Just for to make the concept clear, I am trying to put it all in a short video. Now the next term comes, how we can find out the magnitude of this component. So here we can see again, I have shown the case 1 related example here, and the F force has resolved into the two force component Fx and Fy. So this resolution is related to the type 1 mutually perpendicular orthogonal component system. Now remember the formula only. I will show you how that formula comes in the next lecture, but today, for today, you have to remember this. For the Fx component, and always consider the theta with the horizontal. The theta should be made with the horizontal. So this x is the horizontal surface, and with that horizontal, theta is the angle made by the F force. Okay, when the theta with the horizontal, then that time we will use this formula. For the Fy component, I will use Fy equal to F into sine theta. And for the Fx, the Fx is equal to F into cos theta. For the x component, cos theta. Because all for the horizontal, we always take the cos theta when the theta is making with the horizontal. So for the Fx component, formula will be Fx is equal to F into cos theta. F is the main force component and cos theta is the related to the angle. And Fy, for the Fy component, Fy equal to F into sine theta. These two formula we need to remember. In tomorrow's lecture, I will revise these all, and also will tell you how that formula comes. Here I mention Fx is toward the right side and Fy toward the upside. So the side of this force component is really, really important, because on the basis of the direction, the sign convention is different. If the right side is there, that means it will be positive. If we consider the upward side, means it will be negative. If the downside means negative, sorry, Fy upside means positive, and Fy is in downside means negative. Fx is in the left side means negative, and Fx is in right side means positive. Don't worry, at the time of numerical all the concept will be clear. Okay, this is all about the magnitude when the component are related to the orthogonal. Then second thing, magnitude of component F1 and F2. So when the non-perpendicular system, that time we will get the two component F1 and F2. Why not we are getting the Fx and Fy? Because the resolution of the F force is not on the axis, doesn't lie on the X and Y axis. Okay, so that's why it's we will not going to write here the Fx and Fy. We are going to mention here the F1 and F2 for our clarification. So again the formula is here F1. So for your remembering purpose, I will tell you the one thing. When we think about the F1 formula, F1 component formula, take the angle in between the other two forces. So the formula is F1 equal to main component F into sine beta, and in below sine in bracket alpha plus beta. For the F2 component, again the reverse situation is there. Main component F into which angle we will take? We will take the other two forces angle. So other two forces are F and F1. In between the alpha is there. So F into sine alpha, and in below as mentioned sine alpha plus beta. So bottom side is same for both these. At the top we are getting the two little changes, that alpha and beta. So remember these two formula, and always remember how we made it. So this is all about the formulae. The example on orthogonal component. Now we have seen the case 1, where we can do the resolution of forces into the two component by orthogonally, but then on the basis of nature of forces, the resolution is going to affect on its sign convention and all. Today we will not discuss this point. In the tomorrow's lecture I will clear the sign conventions of all, but when the condition comes about the resolutions, you should be able. So when the pulling forces means away from the origin. So again I represent here the quadrant. This is the quadrant, and this force is in the first quadrant. Okay, now this force, this is the origin, and this force is moving away from the origin. This force is not coming toward the origin, this force is going away from the origin. So in that case, the resolution, how that resolution will be, that resolution will be, again I will do this way. Okay, so this horizontal component, this is the orthogonal component, means the horizontal and vertical component we will draw here. So two forces will be perpendicular to each other mutually. So horizontal component will be Fx and vertical component will be Fy, correct. Now for the second quadrant, here the diagram of second quadrant has mentioned. This is the second quadrant. Okay, and again the nature of force is pulling type. So the resolutions we will do here, the arrow is going in this direction, so resolution will be upward, and we will take here this in this direction. Okay, we couldn't take the resolutions if the force is going this, we couldn't take the resolution in this direction. Okay, so it's a normal thing that we can resolve the forces in this direction, correct. Then the second thing, so this force, horizontal force means the Fx force, and vertical force means again the Fy force. And third is related to the third quadrant diagram. Again I will show the force direction is in the downward, so I will show the Fy force is in the downward and Fx force is in horizontal but toward the left side. So this will be the Fy force and this will be the Fx force, correct. Okay, I hope that you understood the concept of resolution of the forces, but I still tell you, do the practice of these resolutions quadrant wise, and you will get the whole concept related to it, no doubt. Now the second step is the push type nature. When the forces are push type, so when we talk about the push type force, that means the forces are not going away from the origin, the forces going toward the origin, forces are coming toward the origin. So here we can see the F direction is toward the origin, so this is the origin, so F is coming toward the origin. Okay, and when I resolve this F forces into the two component, then I will get due to the downward direction, I will resolve this force into these two component. So downward, this force is going downward, so Fy will be in a downward direction, Fy, and this force will be the Fx force. Okay, and this resolution also the same as like the pulling forces, but with the practice you will get the whole things are easy. Now here in the third quadrant, again the nature of the forces is the push type, because the force is moving toward the origin. So when the time comes to resolve the forces, then I will resolve this way. So this horizontal force is nothing but the Fx, and vertical force means Fy. Always remember, horizontal forces are related to the Fx, and vertical forces will be indicated by the Fy in orthogonal method. Okay, I hope this concept is also clear. Now the next step is third number, resolution of forces when it lies on x and y axis. Now the sometime that forces may not be making the angle theta with the horizontal. They may be having the theta is equal to 0. When we talk about the theta equal to 0, that means that force is having the 0 angle with the horizontal. So 0 angle with the horizontal means that forces will be lying on the same line. So related to the horizontal, if I consider theta equal to 0, then that force might be lying on the x axis. So this force component is nothing but the F. The F is the different one. Due to the theta is equal to 0, that force will lie on the same axis. So when the times come to resolve these forces, we will get the only one component, that component related to the x, because that F is present on the x axis only. Theta is 0, that's why the other component we will not get. This is the one. Now here I will show for the first quadrant, if we consider the F force lies on the x axis, then the resolution of the component will be only one, that is the Fx. When the F lies on the y axis, then that F is nothing but we will consider Fy. Okay, because when the force lies on the axis, it is impossible to resolve into the two component, because due to the theta angle. If you do the practice, you have the formula, you can put the theta value into the formula, then automatically you will get the answer related to it. When the we consider the F force on this x negative side, then also this F will be Fx and the Fy component will be absent. Here the Fx component will be absent. F is equal to Fy we will consider, and here again on the x axis, due to x axis, F is equal to Fx. This is all about when the resolution of forces, when the forces lies on the x axis and y axis. So it is the normal thing, when there is a theta angle, certain angle, F is making with the horizontal surface, then there is the chances of getting the resolution of component. Okay, but when the F lies on at 90 degree, then again and 180 degree, 270 degree, then again the component we will not get, only the one component will be present there. So don't make it so it may make you confused. So I will not talk more about it. So basic thing is how we can resolve the force component. Now you got the idea about it. Now come to the last thing, and that is the thank you. So do the practice, and in the tomorrow's lecture we will see in detail. Thank you. Thank you very much.